Happy birthday, America.
Welcome to the biggest and best parade in the region, in part because all of you.
That's right. Yesterday, you said this was the biggest 4th of July parade in the world.
I would say the universe.
The universe.
Yes.
All right.
Raise your hand if you agree.
You've been known to exaggerate a little, Jennifer.
No such thing.
No.
One thing I do want to be clear about, this just in, it's hot. I don't know if anyone's noticed. It's a little warm, a little toasty. Obviously, make sure you're drinking that water. There is a cooling station, and I believe some medical professionals on the west lawn, if you will, of Town Hall. Cooling station over there, just in case you do feel a little ugh, and you need to find somewhere to go to cool off. We want to make sure
they have those misting fans over there. I saw
them.
I walked by it. Yeah, it's right over here to our right.
Hello to all the folks watching at home as well. Thanks to iCat. We got a dedicated staff.
That's right, everybody watching at iCat.
Yeah, Nate, Tommy, Ron, Al, and Steven are the team making this up possible. Hi, guys, there.
What's up, guys?
Thanks for your hard work in this heat. We appreciate it. And again, hello and happy 4th to everybody watching at home.
And remember to watch it in December because they replay it about 87 times. And it always warms you up in the middle of December when you're watching the 4th of July parade.
We have an absolutely awesome lineup, some last minute additions, because everyone knows this is the awesome place to be. Before they get here, which is real soon, there are kids activities happening on the West Lawn. They are free. This is sponsored by Excellus, and new this year.
Ooh,
I think
I
Dino
heard.
Needs
this
to,
is cool.
Dino needs to start this. The
I think 180 I'm too fat.
Foot zip line open now.
Yes. If you want to zip over there real quick before the parade gets here. You might have a little time to do that.
Should we mention this looking ahead to
Should we introduce ourselves? We haven't done that yet.
Yes, go ahead. Gentlemen first.
I'm here with Jennifer Johnson from 13 Wham News.
Ah. Hello, friends. Hello, neighbors. The good thing about this is, where do we ever decide, are we a Rondacoiters?
A Rondacoiters. That's what
I
that's no, that's a hashtag now that
We're
I
neighbors.
Created. A Rondacoiters, yes. You live over there, I live over there, though.
This is Dino, yes, both sides representing, but aren't we one? We're one.
That's right.
This is Dino from Fickle.
Yay.
And let's get started.
Let's do it.
We have Officer Rob Lewis and Sergeant Kenneth Gorton from the Irondequoit Police Department.
IPD, let's hear it.
I think this is Rob's favorite thing to do. He's always cruising up and down the street each year.
Oh, yeah.
You see that smile on his face. Today and every day as he serves our community, like so many of the folks we're about to see do.
Says watch for Chief Tantillo. I can't tell if Chief Tantillo is marching here or not.
All right, pageant wave, pageant wave. There you go. Well done. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen of the Irondequoit Police Department.
Officer Lewis, Sergeant Gorton.
Following behind them is the Irondequoit Police Honor Guard, established in the year 2000 and marches annually in Albany on Law Enforcement Memorial Day, which is in May. This unit also participates in the annual Victims' Rights Walk at Highland Park, local parades, the annual EMS service in Irondequoit, and also attends memorial services and funerals of officers killed in the line of duty in New York State, which of course we had this past week with State Trooper Nicholas Clark. I think we can pause for just a moment for a moment of silence for State Trooper Nicholas Clark.
Thank you.
Irondequoit Police Honor Guard.
Thank you to the men and women who serve and protect every day. I'm a proud father of a member of the Irondequoit Police Department.
Yes, you
yes,
are.
I am. My youngest son, Dean. Very proud.
You should be. You very much
and very,
should be.
And very hit home this week.
We have our honorary police
There's
officer,
Chief.
Nolan, Oh, and that guy driving? Yeah, Chief Tantillo. Hey, Chief.
Hey, Chief.
Hey to our honorary police officer, Nolan. And we have another honorary junior police officer. Hello, Ryan. Hello in there.
Hey, Ryan.
And Amelia.
Amelia. All
Ryan
right.
And Amelia. You guys wear Thank those hats well.
You know, they have a great police camp here every summer.
I've heard about
yes,
that.
Yes, Dean, my son who's a police officer, did it back when he was a 12 or 13, yeah, years and years ago. Yeah.
Really?
It's really cool. They get to go out on the sheriff boat. They get fire weapons. Yeah, it's, yeah, they learn a lot, yeah.
And now all these years later,
it's part in
sworn in member of the Ronnie Quinn Police
yeah,
Department.
A couple years now.
That's fantastic.
How cool is that? Just another one of the cool things that offered here in Irondequoit.
So much.
With all the summer programs.
Irondequoit means we offer a lot. No, it doesn't. I know it doesn't, but it should, right? We have so much to celebrate in our community, including the East Irondequoit Lancer Marching Band.
There they are. You know, they got a pass from Carol, the boss of the parade. You know, she's the chief, the head cheese of the parade, and she
Carol
gave
Wayne.
Them a pass on wearing their uniforms today.
Yes. Carol Wayne, so everyone knows who works so hard
That's
on the
That's her Carol
that.
Payment right here.
Yes.
This parade doesn't happen without her.
That's for sure. And she's the one who said, yeah, polyester, mm-mm, don't have to wear it today.
You can also blame her for asking Jennifer and I to do this.
By the way, do you like Dino's shirt?
You like this shirt?
I picked it out
Jen
for
found
him.
It for me. She shot me a picture of it the other day. She goes, you should wear this.
Gotta take care of my co-MC, you know? So the 2018 Lancer Marching Band will be presenting the Wild West, featuring music from the motion pictures The Magnificent Seven and Blazing Saddles. Staff includes Jeff Hoffman, Francois Auclair, Lisa Weiland, Kyle Reagan, Erica Vagarese, Kayla Jerusal, and Michael Simpson. I apologize for butchering the name.
That's right. You want your name butchered? Just hire us.
The apology stands. We'll say it now, and it stands.
We'll just put it out there right now. We're going to butcher your name. Your name's not Smith. You're in trouble.
This band is made up of students in grades 6 through 12, and they want to make sure they say they are so grateful for the tremendous support of the booster organization Eastridge Parents for Music and the East Irondequoit Central School District. Do we have any band families here tonight or today?
Past state champions, too. That was a good idea, Carol. No uniform. That was a great idea.
Jackets, no hats.
No jackets, no hats, right.
Jersey.
kind of like that look. Erica Vajersey.
Thank you.
I got the lowdown.
I know I sound like Sarah Palin here, but I can hear the band from my house. They practice a lot and sound great. And couldn't do it with all the folks who make this possible, right? Thank you for all your
help. You go, the crew.
Got to have the crew. East Irondequoit Lancers, let's hear it.
Our
there he is.
Supervisor, the one, the only, Supervisor Dave Seeley.
And new band MC around here, too.
Along with John Perticone. There he is, tossing the candy. Kimmy Romeo.
Kimmy Romeo.
There she is. Peter Wetter.
Hi, Peter.
Nicole. Hush Lorraine. There she is. There's Peter. Thanks, for guys, for serving our community on town council. Hello, Lauren. Looking good in the car. Patriotic as ever.
Okay. Oh, town historian Pat Wayne was there, too. In that group. Yes.
Oh, there she was.
Town historian, Pat Wayne. There he is.
The shyest guy in the parade.
Judge Janier.
Is that assault? I'll see you in your courtroom. No, thank you.
He walked by me last night. He goes, I'm not here. I'm like, oh.
The one, okay. The only.
I'm mistaken.
Judge Joe Janier. And a guy who comes with his own built-in cheering squad, his family, Judge Joe Valentino.
There he is.
Raise your hand if your last name is Valentino. I told ya.
How you doing, Judge?
They can be patriotic and skate all at the same time.
Oh, man, look at this.
This Valentino family is impressive. Hi, guys. Happy 4th.
Happy 4th of July.
Love it when these folks, you know, they grow up here and they, you know, stay here and serve our communities. It's pretty cool.
Judge Patrick Roussey. There he is. How's it going?
Hello,
not
sir.
Too bad. Beautiful day.
Happy 4th.
Happy 4th of July. Dr. Joe, the president of our county legislature, right there. Dr. Joe, with office right down the street.
One of the sponsors of the parade. Thank
That's
you so
right.
much.
Thank you. There's Mary.
Hi, Mary.
Hey, Mary.
Hi, everyone. Always got a big group today. That translates to lots of candy.
Yeah.
I caught one piece, and it's something I don't like.
You eat candy, I don't think it affects your feet. He's a foot doctor, so
yeah, that's
maybe
right.
That's okay.
That's right.
Softest hands in town, too. You ever shook hands with Dr. Joe?
Yeah.
He has the softest hands.
All right, then.
I mean, if he works on your feet, too,
hey.
It helps. It's true.
We want to mention Senator Rich Funke was not able to join us today, but also a sponsor of the fireworks tonight.
Right.
So if you see Senator Funke around sometime soon, make sure you say
thanks
to
Rich.
Him. All right, this one is always impressive to me. Major General Robert Norple. Norbert Rappel. I butchered that. I apologize. This is our thing, though. We've done this for so many years. I apologize for getting it wrong. In this 62 red Corvette driven by Bill Bennion. If you want to see some real life history, you Google his name. Fascinating story.
Here's our American Legion Post 134. The Irondequoit American Legion Post 134, established in 1928. It has consistently helped out with many organizations and programs throughout Irondequoit and the surrounding area. Post 134 maintains a strong presence in our town by sponsoring and preserving the observance of patriotic holidays such as Memorial Day, the parade, Flag Day, Veterans Day. We have left our mark on several of the town's locations such as the cemetery, town hall grounds, community center, and Camp Eastman by installing several memorial flagpoles and playground equipment. By checking out our website, you become aware of what war veterans have given to our community and continue to with the American Legion Post 134. Thank you very much.
Speaking of, the Korean War Veterans Association rolling through right now. Roger Hill, president of Monroe County Chapter 58. This is the 68th anniversary of the start of the Korean War, and all participants are over 85 years old. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for being here. Thank you, gentlemen. To Gabriel Martinez of Troop 37, who is honoring the family member of Arcadio Vargas, who served in the Korean War, carrying the banner today, and Zachary Stort of Troop 183, honoring all veterans who served in the Korean War.
Thank you so much. Over 85 still kick our butt. Let's hear for these gentlemen. Love these guys. The Vietnam Veterans of America, Chapter 20. They salute our country and fellow veterans of all eras. They invite you, everyone, to visit the Vietnam Veterans Memorial of Greater Rochester, located in Highland Park. If you've never seen it, it is truly an amazing, amazing place.
Winter, spring, summer, fall, all seasons.
It's gorgeous.
Always beautiful. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. And coming up now, the Navy Operational Support Center, Rochester, responsible for the readiness of more than 125 selected reserve sailors who make up five diverse units, which provide operational capabilities to their supportive active duty commands fleet-wide. The Navy Operational Support Center, Rochester, also supports the families of those reserve sailors deployed in support of military operations worldwide. The staff comprised of 10 full-time support sailors.
Thank you, Navy Operational Center. The Blue Star Mothers of New York State, Coordinator Chloe Alexander. They are the moms in and around Rochester who are now have or had had sons and daughters honorably serving the United States military. Their mission is to support one another and all members of the armed forces and their families through a variety of activities and events. They are strictly nonpartisan and non-political. The Blue Star Mothers of New York 8.
Our first fire department of the day. In case you hadn't heard, here comes the Seabreeze Fire District. Let's hear it if you live in the Seabreeze Fire District.
The town's oldest fire company since 1908. It's their 110th year.
Woo!
It's an all-volunteer fire department.
Woo!
Good thing there's an ambulance right behind them. Their fire apparatus include the chief car, engine 195, ambulance 199, the hovercraft, one of our favorite residents of Irondequoit, coming up soon, the rescue craft 196, and about 20 marchers. Chief Dave DeRoller.
Where is the chief? We gotta look for him somewhere.
Hey, Seabreeze.
I like the decals.
Yeah.
It feels funny to talk about Christmas time now, but have you ever been to the Seabreeze Winter Carnival?
The Seabreeze, that is a great parade, too.
If you haven't been to it, there's the chief. Hey, chief.
There's chief.
Good to see you, loud as always.
Coming up this Saturday. Right on, right down King's Highway. That's a crazy thing. And there she is, Irondequoit's favorite. Fran Beth from Marges celebrating their 58th anniversary.
Woo!
Nice day to head to Marges, I believe. Stay back 200 feet. Fran should have that on her at all times.
We might have had, oh, here it is, the Irondequoit Ambulance and Explorer Post. Showing up now, providing pre-hospital care to more than 4,500 jobs per year, 4 ambulances, 3 staff with advanced life support during the day, and 2 crews or trucks on the overnight shift. We're proud to offer professional life-saving support 24 hours a day, and in this changing landscape for this industry, we know they are working harder than ever. Thanks for being there for us 24/7 in some of our most vulnerable times.
Irondequoit Bureau of Recreation, all every year with their 4th of July bike decorating contest. And we want to congratulate the girls 5-7. Third place, Chloe Burnett. Second place, Adeline Dentz. And first place, girls 5-7, Stella Franz. And then the girls 8 and up, third place, Sadie O'Neill. Second place, Amelia Mulcahy. And first place, Mari Tucker. Nice job. Look at those bikes. Beautiful job. Way to go, ladies. That's getting in the spirit right there.
From the Irondequoit Town Camps right at Durand Eastman Park just last week. My kids were there. So
great recreational department in town here.
We appreciate your hard, hot work. I like the pipes. I like the drums.
Yes, and here they come.
Here they come. We're rappers. This is the Rochester Scottish Pipes and Drums, established in 1919. So I'm going to quickly do the math, the 99th year. It's the region's oldest continuous Scottish pipe band, and we'll be celebrating, yes, its centennial next year. Uniform is modeled after the 42 Regiment of Foot, Royal Highlanders, Scotland's famous Black Watch, performed with the West Point military tattoo for the past 6 years, marched in Boston's St. Patrick's Day Parade, and performed in numerous parades and Celtic festivals. The mission remains the same, to play traditional Scottish and Celtic music and honor the heroes of our many conflicts. Look us up on Facebook, they say.
And they all stopped at the Titus Tavern when they rounded the corner, you know, for a shot of scotch, right? Over there. I don't know how you blow on a day like today.
That's just cool. I want to learn how to play that. That's just cool.
Here comes the St. Paul Fire District, established in 1924, their 93rd year. Chief William Durland and Assistant Chief Stuart Bell. Special thanks to their 8 veteran activity members. They had 2,045 calls for service in 2017. Wow. They have an Explorer program for students 18 to 14, and they're always looking for volunteers. There's the St. Paul Fire District right there.
Who lives in the St. Paul Fire District? Let's hear it from you guys.
That would be me.
Let's hear your thanks for these dedicated men and women. Did you mention the 8 active veteran members?
I thought I did. It's got to be the 93rd year. We've got some very well-established fire departments in this town. Over 2,000 calls. Wow. These guys are busy.
They got the fancy electronic sign out front. I know they had their... Hey, Bobby! Hey!
Their equipment. Quint 152 Engine 2. 1C15, 1C25, 1517 Squad, and the Chief's car. About 20 marchers. Thank you, gentlemen.
Looking good, looking good. Everyone wants the convertible today, right?
We might find them in a beverage tent later.
Can you blame them? I don't think so.
Not at all.
All right, check. How's everyone doing? I see you drinking water. That's good. Everyone take a drink of water
Everybody
right now.
Everybody feeling all right?
Okay. Don't be afraid to check out that cooling station, as we say, on the West Lawn of Irondequoit Town Hall. You have to say West Lawn when you say it. And who has tried
it's
the
over
zip
there.
Line? Anyone tried the zip line yet? It's open.
Any zip liners?
180 feet. You have to be 40 pounds, at least. And it's free. It's free.
Absolutely. Wow, I might have to try that.
Yeah, we got to do that before we go.
I probably weigh too much.
It's free thanks to Excellus. I bet these, this next group could zip line no problem.
250, I'm just under.
This is TNT Dance Explosion.
Watch out. Woo! They're going to explode.
A hometown dance studio with worldwide appeal. Both recreational and competitive dances are taught in an encouraging, fun atmosphere by highly trained teachers. Summer dance classes and camp are open for registration, and fall classes too if you're a planner like I am. Come join us, they say. They're right on Titus Avenue.
Owned and operated by Joel Taylor and Heather Trubb. The TNT Dance Explosion.
Dino would show you his cartwheel, but he doesn't want to show anyone up.
Yeah,
so
it's ugly.
Maybe in the beer tent later?
Yeah, in the beer tent later. The beverage tent.
Beverage.
It says on the thing, beverage tent.
Yes, beverage. That's code for beverage.
Here comes those clowns again. Can't have a parade without these clowns.
How you guys doing in the parade? It's a little bit of a ways, huh? You're in the home stretch. You're almost there. You almost made it. Thanks for working so hard today and making our parade awesome. And here they go.
All right.
Hey, ladies. They got the wave.
We're playing
on.
September on July 4th.
Hi, ladies. Happy 4th of July.
Look at this guy.
Hey, bud.
What's in the bucket, buddy?
He's got the wave down. Happy 4th of July.
That's a cool hat. That's what I got to get next year.
The mayor? He's the self-dubbed mayor of the parade.
Okay.
I like that. A man who stakes his claim.
Here's those clowns. I knew they were coming.
Mr. Supervisor, there's your competition right there.
The Grease Paint Alley Clowns. Sally Stutzman, the president. Maureen Morgan, the business manager. Grease Paint Alley Clowns. You want to do it? No, you go.
I'm doing it after you.
Okay. Grease Paint. Where am I? Grease Paint Alley Clowns have been in existence for 39 years. They're all volunteers and proud to serve our community with smiles and laughter. We have clown classes available and would welcome some new faces. I think they're talking to you, Dave Seeley.
Thank you, clowns. Everyone, before our next great marches, just give it up for Jennifer Johnson and Dino Kay, who do this every year. They live in Irondequoit. Give them a big round of applause for doing this on their holiday. Thank them both.
Thank you.
Thank you, Dave.
You make me feel like I can stand tall as I walk around town. This
high
tall.
High five for you, then.
Hi, thanks. High five.
Oh, good job, guys.
You got the best view of the parade.
Ah, the club we all want to be in.
One day.
Someday.
One day. Yeah, celebrating over 59 years with more than 500 members. What are we doing wrong? One of the largest clubs in the U.S., the Rochester
60?
Corvette Club. A social club with always a worthy charity for the year. This year it is the Miracle Field, not too far away, in Webster. For children and adults with special needs, they're hoping to build a clubhouse there. The ribbon cutting for this amazing field was last year. Check it out, Ridge Road, right near Webster Town Hall. It's got so much, but again, these are the folks who are trying to build a clubhouse to make that awesome field complete.
That's very patriotic. Look at that one. Very nice. You know, last week was the anniversary. The very first Corvette came off the line in 1953.
Really?
Yes. Yeah, just last week.
Oh, what about you?
He's rocking. Tequila.
Any fender benders this time?
And they are here today in memory of Gene Cameron. Woo.
Got another band coming.
Oh, yes. Speaking of Webster, saw their buses in the parking lot when I pulled in, and I thought, yeehaw, I didn't know they were coming, but awesome to have them. This is the Webster High School Marching Band under the direction of Paul Van Horn.
I don't know if they got the memo that they didn't have to wear their jackets.
Well, please welcome our neighbors to the east.
They know where to come for a good parade, though.
Right.
Thanks for joining us, Webster.
We appreciate the effort on this hot day.
That's right. He's got our own spritzer. That's what I need. We need a spritzer. Maybe we get Don to do that, right?
That's why the supervisor's here.
When he started. just flunked it.
Thank you, Webster.
Thank you, Webster, for joining us.
Now take off those uniforms, put on the t-shirt, and hit the zip line.
That's right. Everybody's talking soccer. The Irondequoit Soccer Club. Been in existence in Irondequoit for over 40 years. The Irondequoit Soccer Club provides the opportunity for school-aged children from Irondequoit and surrounding areas to learn the game of soccer and participate in organized league play. The program includes travel and recreational teams as well as futsal, micro soccer, and top soccer programs for kids with disabilities. Hey, what's up? How are you going, man? I'm going to see you later, right?
I may be the mom of a player on the Galaxy team.
Okay.
I see some Galaxy representing here. Woo!
All right. Do a little bragging. That's cool.
I can. All right. The Irondequoit Ministerial Association representing several Irondequoit faith communities. This is a really cool concept. They meet monthly to share fellowship, ideas, and news about our faith communities and our commitment to the town of Irondequoit. This is the fourth year the churches are walking in the parade together. The whole point is together, hoping to bring people together as we share common goals with our neighbors. And if we can mention November 18th, they invite everyone to their Thanksgiving celebration. So store that away, November 18th. An invitation is out to everybody here.
Coordinated by Donna Mall and Pastor Andrew Gookin. Thanks for joining us. Happy 4th of July. Here they are. Countdown to Bills Camp, St. John Fisher College. This is the Downbeat, the official Bills drum line managed by Don English. Thank you. Dave's ready.
Woo, I can feel this
countdown to camp. Here we go. Irondequoit Department of Public Works, woo, Commissioner Bob Kiley,
Bob
Deputy
Kiley.
Commissioner Mr. Don Sinton. There's Bob.
Woo.
Go, Buffalo. The Irondequoit DPW maintains all the town parks facilities. Irondequoit Town Cemetery, Irondequoit Bay Marine Park, 320 lane miles of road, 150 miles of storm sewers, 171 miles of sanitary sewers, 26 sanitary sewer and sewer pump stations, 294 miles of sidewalks, and approximately 15,700 town trees in the right of way. They also pick up approximately 27,000 cubic yards of brush and respond to approximately 1,600 calls for sanitary sewer service annually. Let's hear it for Irondequoit DPW.
Now,
I want to drive that thing.
Deputy Commissioner, am I right in saying that we are the only town that has a sanitary sewer service annually? That is correct. Another benefit of living where the land and water meets.
Look at Jennifer up on her sewer knowledge.
I am. I know and love my town DPW because, all right, let's face it. The past few years, especially the last two.
Oh, yeah.
It's been a doozy.
Yeah, please.
I mean, already we kind of have this thing called snow, so they're always on top of that. But this thing called wind now? Come on.
And you remember what happened to their barn?
There was that.
Right, there was that.
There was that.
They broke ground on a new facility.
Yeah, tell us about it, Supervisor.
Can we talk about something else? Give it up for Dino Kay and Jennifer Johnson for jinxing us for the rest of 2018.
No, I just have to add, I got a chance to do a ride along with one of the plow operators. That job is intense. If you think that job is easy, you are wrong. You climb into the cab with one of those plows, you will be mightily impressed by the job these men and women do.
I think I hit a sore spot there, huh?
Irondequoit means where it's always 75 and sunny. Is that what it means? Here comes the LBS Highlanders with a history of more than a decade of playing together. Although a lot of them have known each other longer, they're family and friends. They make up the band of pipers and drummers whose passion is to practice, play, and perform.
Pipe Major Chris Sullivan and business contact Dave Barrett. The LBS Highlander Pipes and Drums.
I love it. They say, let us become your tradition.
I like that. It's a good tradition.
I feel like more and more of the bands want to come and play and add to our town tradition. Glenn Peck. Hi, friend. Nice to see ya. You always spot me. This time I spotted you. Happy 4th, my friend.
Point Pleasant Fire District here in their 103rd year. Chief Peter Clark, Deputy Chief Jeff Champion, proudly serving the residents of Irondequoit for 103 years, the Point Pleasant Fire District is accepting applications for firefighters now. Let them train you to help our community. The Point Pleasant Fire District equipment, engine 112, 114, 115, and rescue 118. With the very cool green trucks.
That's how, right?
I always remember Point Pleasant.
Right? And we gotta ask, who's in the Point Pleasant Fire District? Let's hear ya.
Who's in the Point Pleasant Fire District? Let's hear it.
You got, yes, you are. And we say thank you for serving our community.
Hi, Scoop. Sweaty. Sorry, they're not coyotes.
I was just out here a week ago at the Irondequoit Farmers Market. Who's been to the Irondequoit Farmers Market recently? brought home some great produce, some amazing pies. Oh, the pies, the kettle corn, the pizzas. Ah.
She's an all-American girl.
Our farmer's market is a staple in the Irondequoit community. Each week, approximately 1,200 visitors come to the market for fruits, veggies, crafts, flowers, live entertainment. Just last weekend, my brother-in-law was shaving beards to raise money for 1330 Cancer Connect. You never know what you're going to find at the farmer's market. It's run by town staff and a very dedicated group of volunteers. A special thank you to Donna Pecora, our market manager.
Yay!
Her 10th season with the market.
Followed closely by the Boy Scouts of America Seneca Waterways Council, directed by David Stickney. The Boy Scouts of America provide programs for youth and young adults to build character based on the Scouts' oath and law. Irondequoit is the home of the Bay Waters District and their many youths, Cub Scouts, Boy Scouts, Explorers, and Venturers. Thank you for the youth work that you do. It's so hard, and many volunteers to support and deliver these programs of the Boy Scouts of America Seneca Waterways Council here in Irondequoit, the Bay Waters District.
Watch out for these guys.
Yeah, woo! I'm glad they're my friends and neighbors, because this is intimidating. Credup Karate, a family-oriented martial arts academy working with children and adults. Students are involved in competition and work hard developing self-defense skills. Discipline, respect, and self-confidence are life skills students develop at Credup's Karate Academy.
Irondequoit Rotary, there's Dave Shaheen. Hello, Dave. Luda Prima is coordinator, Dave Shaheen is the president, and the Irondequoit Rotary is celebrating 51 years of service in Irondequoit and continue Rotary's worldwide effect. Just handing me candy, I like that. Eradicate polio. Rotary's motto is service above self, and they practice that motto by providing scoreboards at the all-new baseball fields, and they continue to promote literacy through the distribution of dictionaries at all third graders in Irondequoit, and also started the Little Book House Project. The Rotary annually donates 100 food baskets to the Irondequoit Community Cupboard. In addition to providing summer camping experiences for children with special needs, they also are a major sponsor of the member of the drug-free Irondequoit, Defy, and they help with the opioid crisis. Thank you, Dave, and all the Rotarians here today. Thank you, guys.
And special guest back from Florida, Suzanne Masters, former supervisor 1994 to 1995. Welcome home.
Hey, Dom.
Look at us, man.
Did you
what
bring
do
us
we do
this
to get all the candy?
Oh my goodness. What's the year on that car? 1931. My goodness. Shiny, shiny.
And 31 and an 18.
Probably has better hauling capabilities. Smart choice.
Is this the Little League? I believe it is.
Thank you, Dino.
Irondequoit Little League. Board President Dave Calero, united in one vision as one community for baseball and softball in Irondequoit. We are Irondequoit Little League. Irondequoit Little League is in its 65th year. As a member of the New York District 4, providing best baseball, softball experiences available for every player at any skill. Little League has instilled leadership, character, courage, and loyalty in all that participate, including the nearly 1.5 million adult volunteers. Little League can be found in more than 80 countries worldwide, with more than 2.4 million children participating each year. Little League is the largest youth sports organization in the world, and we got a good one right here in Irondequoit. We got
sure
some
do.
Really nice ball fields, too.
We sure do. They look great. Hey, we need a dance interlude. Dance interlude
another
time. The White Sabres Drum and Bugle Corps, under the direction of President and Director Pete Amico. White Sabres Drum and Bugle Corps celebrating their 90th anniversary this year. None of you look that old.
It's their first time in our parade, too.
Well, welcome.
Welcome, guys. What took you so long?
Yeah, shout out to Guard 18. Oh, I guess they all are. Walking with a walking cast, by the way. I'm impressed.
They got the memo.
The White Sabres Drum and Bugle Corps, Peter Amico, Drum Director.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have a lost little girl that we have in our command center. She's safe. Her name is Sammy Urban, and she was with her grandfather, Carl Masters. So Carl Masters, if you are out there, please go to the command center on the east, on the west side of the town hall.
Thank you, Mr. Don.
All right, we're all good. Thanks, Mr. Don. We are all good. Welcome to the Laurelton Fire Department. Coming up from the south side of our town. Celebrating 93 years of service and featuring the new engine in the parade.
Very nice.
Shiny and nice. Engine 162 just joining the fleet in May. I like the bunting. I'm sure it doesn't always last, though. Also, save the date, Laurelton Open House will be Saturday, September 29th at the Laurelton Fire Department on Empire Boulevard.
Chief Charles Ingersoll from Laurelton Fire District.
Who's in the Laurelton District? Let's hear you.
Who's in the Laurelton District?
The Finger Lakes Region Volkswagen Club. They got the convertible memo. Smart. Very, very smart. Natural air conditioning. Formed 28 years ago and going strong with 40 members in and around the Rochester area. They share a love for all types of vintage and new Volkswagens. They hold monthly events such as cruises and car shows.
I thought this was Herbie the Love Bug here for a minute.
She's got the Steelers terrible fan. Towel.
I could use a terrible towel right now.
Did she meet the Buffalo Bills band? I wonder what would happen.
Good thing we didn't line up against them.
Good thing we're all Americans today, right?
Here comes Murray's Marshalls Art Center. Murray's Marshall Art Center has been serving the community of Irondequoit for over 40 years. They help men, women, and children become their best versions of themselves through martial arts. Mike Richards, the manager.
Hey, guys.
At Murray's.
Oos.
Grandma and...
How did I do? Oos. Yeah? Oos.
Our lost child is no longer lost, just so you know.
Awesome.
Good news.
My family's been trying this out. We've had so much fun. I recommend Murray's Martial Arts Center right there, right in town. We've had a lot of fun.
Rival dojos next to each other.
Uh-oh. Watch out.
Note the separation.
Yes.
No, they always say it's not about violence.
No.
It's about learning discipline, self-control. So just being your best self.
That's it. Master Kim's Taekwondo Institute. At MasterKims.com. Well represented here at the Irondequoit Parade today. Welcome, everybody.
Oh, what'd they do with it?
Let's see it, Ethan. Woo, those are some kicks.
Master Woo! Kim's Taekwondo Institute of Rochester voted Rochester's number one martial arts studio by 10NBC, Rochester Rocks, and DC Rochester's Choice Awards by teaching Taekwondo in Irondequoit to people of all ages for 28 years. Their programs are dedicated to teaching the physical aspects, but also instilling valuable character traits in each student, such as respect, self-discipline, confidence, and self-control. They're located in Culver Ridge Plaza and is the only Kikiwan certified school in the area. Classes begin at age 4 to adult. All right.
All right. Welcome to Irondequoit We say this to the Hilton Crimson Cadets Marching Band, one of the premier performing ensembles of the Hilton Central School District. And student drum majors Amanda Bush and Michael Franzak. The cadets have performed all over the world, from Canada to Germany and Japan. So welcome to Irondequoit. They also compete in the New York State Field Band Conference each fall. Thank you for visiting us here in Irondequoit this 4th of July.
That's also a Weezer song now, you know that, Dave? This truck looks crazy
cool.
They
don't mess around. They don't mess around. That sounds like a Bill Berkovich.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, that's
Berkey. Just guessing.
It's got to be Berkey.
Eyes on the road.
How are you?
Keep your eyes on the road, please.
Hey, tell us about your ride.
That's a cool truck. Look at that thing.
Free tour from the firehouse anytime anybody wants to see it. She's brand new.
You know, little Bill Berkovich story? Firefighter, right?
Right.
Also, RTS bus driver.
Uh-huh.
One day, driving his bus, looks up. There is a house on fire. He says to his riders, "Sorry, I got to put on my other hat." Runs in, rescues someone out of the building. I kid you not.
That
then gets
like
back
Bill
on his bus and finishes his route.
Hey,
that's
it's
Bill
Mike
Berkovich,
Johansson,
ladies and gentlemen. Yes, you should. Those are the heroes we have just wandering around our town doing good things.
Maybe you want to MC for a little bit? Your mom's a pro, isn't she? Dino's all right, too. Dino, so where's Dino? Where's your Uncle Sam out? Huh?
Jennifer told me not to wear it this year. It's going to be too hot.
All right, quick check. How's everyone doing? Take a sip of water. Don't forget that cooling station just in case you need it. All right.
Comes our county executive, Cheryl Donolfo.
Getting in their miles these holidays.
That's right. Her husband, Judge Donolfo.
Representing all of Monroe County, but home in Irondequoit.
That's right. She knows where to live. They know.
Happy 4th, everyone.
How's it going, guys?
Hey, Larry.
Happy 4th of July. Judge Anne Marie Taddeo.
Also from Irondequoit. They all are.
Yeah.
Running for re-election for Supreme Court judge.
Very nice. Good luck.
We kind of run everything. Have you noticed?
Yeah.
We are.
We're the center of the
universe.
Everyone
traces the roots back to one of our high schools, I feel like.
Back to the Junior Eagles.
Here comes the Junior Eagles, kicking off their second season with a new name in the 55th season serving boys and girls of Irondequoit. Their mission is simple, to provide a supportive environment for children
to master the experience needed to excel in cheer and football while learning life skills and sportsmanship, teamwork, good citizenship, and leadership. Come watch the Junior Eagles as they play on Sundays at Irondequoit High School Stadium this fall. The Irondequoit Junior Eagles. Chris Dugan, president.
Does she have her license? Oh. I gotta get a picture of this. Too cute. Too cute. Irondequoit also means home of cute children.
Cute children, yes. Yes.
And cute coaches. Yes, you got it. So they are on land. Hey, guys. We also have those who go by sea. The Gator Swim Club.
Good day to be in the swim club, I believe.
Yes. Can we all jump in the pool afterwards?
Coordinated by Mike Akins.
For almost four decades, the Irondequoit Gator Swim Club has been teaching Irondequoit youth the sport of competitive swimming. Practice is held 5 days a week at both the East Ridge and West Irondequoit pools. Hi there.
Oh, I gotta aim that thing over here.
Sport enjoyed by folks at any age, be it 8 or 80. The Gators are here to get you started in a sport for a lifetime. I've heard folks start as young as 6.
Here's my sport, the Irondequoit Youth Lacrosse. Irondequoit Youth Lacrosse, been a staple in our community since 1957. There are currently around 200 boys and girls in the program from K through 6th grade. This year they will have 11 teams competing against other towns in Monroe County. Our groups provide a unique and affordable opportunity for kids to play lacrosse, the best game ever. It emphasizes developing positive self-esteem, good sportsmanship, fitness, and teamwork through the great game of lacrosse. Let's hear it for Irondequoit Youth Lacrosse.
Irondequoit also means we're really good at lacrosse.
That's right, we are.
Yeah. It's meant like 15 things already.
Comes the Trail Diggers.
Again, the natural air conditioning, you gotta love it this time of year. Local Jeep and 4x4 Club. We make events for local enthusiasts to go to and have fun, encouraging family participation, and try to do all we can to help our community.
There they are, the Trail Diggers. Those are some cool rigs, too.
I like it when they combine their interests, you know, with the Jeeps.
Right.
You know, community interests, giving back.
Absolutely. Amen. Birds of a feather, right? Flock together and four-wheel together.
Does that minion have its license? Yeah. I think the police chief is around here somewhere. Shh.
Scully's here. He knew he'd be here.
That's just a cool name, Trail Diggers.
Trail, yeah.
I want a sweatshirt that says that.
They probably have that. There's a bunch of them.
All right, just about 12:30. We've been at this for an hour and a half now. Again, don't forget to hydrate. Feel free to find some shade. Those kids' activities are open now on the west lawn of the town hall. And again, don't forget that. Hey, Mike. Don't forget the zip line. All of these events free thanks to Excellus.
Hey, remember, there's music tonight, too, in the beverage tent?
The beverage tent.
That's right. Inside Out Band starts at 1. And then if you're an Eagles fan, you got to catch. I saw these guys at the Lilac Festival. Lion Eyes. They start at 6:30. Eagles tribute band. Really good. If you're an Eagles fan, got to check them out. And that's all, of course, before the fireworks.
Give it up for my mom, Karen Seeley, for telling me which bands to book.
That's right. Mr. Yes. Mustard last night, right?
Mom is always right. Mom is
especially
always,
his mom.
Can my kids hear that? Mom is always right. All right, Zalika Shepherd, candidate for Monroe County Family Court Judge. Making those heels work.
Yeah. You're a brave, brave woman. Once again, we want to thank the sponsors to make all this happen. Of course, tonight's fireworks brought to you by Senator Rich Funky. I thank him. Also, our other sponsors, Joe Morelli Jr. and Sr., and Dr. Joe Carbone, all big sponsors of the festivities here in Irondequoit, the best 4th of July around.
All right. Christopher Chacho, candidate for Monroe County. State Supreme Court, excuse me. Got to update my listing here. There he is. Again, you're always one of my favorite ties. as if walking enough wasn't enough today, you brought a little extra with you.
That's right, little.
Your grandson, Tony. Welcome, right. Tony.
Vote for his papa for Supreme Court. That's what Tony says.
Another sponsor
yes,
of the
one of our sponsors.
Today, Assembly Majority Leader Joe Morelli and candidate for Congress.
Congress. There he is. Joe. Then, of course, the chip off the old block, Joe Jr., our county legislator. Joe Morelli Jr., and again, another one of our sponsors here today.
And happy belated birthday to Jonas. 3 yesterday. Yay. Happy birthday, Jonas.
This is my neighbor.
Ah, yes. Hey, guys.
Where is
Deputy
there's
County
Adam.
Clerk Jeff McCann.
And the man himself, right over there. Let's hear another Irondequoiter running this county, Adam Bello.
Yes. Raleigh's
Monroe
Bellows.
County Clerk.
Also, a former, maybe sometimes current, Irondequoit Gator. Yes? Yes. How many years swimming? 15 years. And how many years coaching? 4 years coaching.
Hi, Adam.
Hey, Jack. Fatima Reed, welcome to our parade.
Hi, Fatima. Welcome to Irondequoit.
Residents.
Vote November 6th.
How is it to walk down Titus? Yes? You seem fresh as a daisy. How does she look so fresh? I am melting up here.
Jen Lunsford, running for state senate. Welcome. Running for state senate, Jen Lunsford. Yay, there she is.
Hey, Jen.
Dave didn't think he heard me.
So Jen in the red, in the blue, Jamie Romeo.
Jamie Romeo.
New York State
Hi,
Assembly.
Jamie.
District 136. I'm sorry. Yes, 136 for Jamie. Also looks fresh as a daisy. How is that possible?
Yeah, exactly. Robin.
From the Brighton Town Board, now running for Assembly. Now we got to give give a shout out to a lot of these folks. A lot of them just walked in the Fairport Parade as well. So they're doing at least double, maybe even triple, maybe even quadruple.
They might have another one after this. Also running for Congress, this is Dr. Jim Maxwell. Welcome to Irondequoit, Doctor.
Your workplace for so many years. Yup. Yes, workplace at RGH for so many years. How's everyone feeling? Anyone need a doctor? We got one. We got one.
Is there a doctor in the parade? Yes, there is. A couple of them.
Alicia Mazzo, welcome to our parade.
Alicia.
Thanks for walking today. Candidate for Family Court in Monroe County.
Welcome to Irondequoit.
18 years of experience, she wants you all to know. Thank everyone who has made it this far. We're not done yet.
I hear
the
music.
We're getting close. Yeah. And that's our warning.
While I have the opportunity, this is an event I've been doing for the last couple of years, the Ultimate Brasstacular. It's a benefit concert for the Honor Flight of Rochester. It's Sunday, July 29, over at the Greece American Legion on Dorsey Road. It's a very cool event. And they have a bunch. I mean, I want to say there's like 20 different brass ensembles from all over the state that come over, and we raise a lot of money for Honor Flight Rochester, which, if you're familiar with Honor Flight and the great work that they do in this town, I mean, they have so many flights that take all of our local veterans down to Washington, D.C. and honor them.
Judge Nicole Bailey, welcome. I saw her somewhere there. Maybe talking with folks in the crowd. Candidate for
Judge
Monroe County Family Court. Judge, committed to families. Hello.
Welcome to Irondequoit.
As we get close to our end here, don't forget the reading of the Declaration of Independence happening in about 30 minutes on the steps
on the front
of Town
steps,
Hall.
1 o'clock,
become
yes.
a fun tradition here over the past few years. If you haven't read it or heard it in a while, it kind of takes on some new meaning maybe as you get a little bit older. Again, real quickly to our ICAT team, Nate, Tommy, Ron, Al, Steven, thanks for putting on this production so folks at home can watch. We appreciate the hard work.
Thank you, ICAT people and everybody watching who couldn't come out today. Maybe they couldn't, you know, the weather is not conducive for everybody to join us. So if they're watching at home, thank you.
Carol Payment, you've hit it out of the park once again. Let's hear it for Carol Payment,
Sarah,
who puts this together. Organizes and books so many of the folks who come and walk in our awesome parade. And with that, we introduce Primetime Brass!
There they are.
Under the direction of John Kruger, Lance Reitmeyer, and Billy Ray, proud to once again be invited to perform for the appreciative crowds attending this Irondequoit Annual Parade. Now in its 13th year and recently opened the Rochester International Jazz Festival. Let's hear it for Prime Time Brass.
Let's hear it.
Take it home.
Let's hear it, everybody. Primetime Brass. Thank you. Thank you, Primetime Brass.
One more? Want to do one more?
Why not?
What do you guys think?
One we don't
more?
Want any killing over yeah. here. On
I don't want this to end. Let's do one more.
That's the way to end a parade right there. Primetime Brass.
And that's a wrap. Happy 4th of July.
Happy 4th of July, everybody. Be safe. Make sure you check out the fireworks tonight. We'll see you at the beverage tent, right?